too. Yeah, I can just copy that over and tell you when.
Okay, thank you.
Wait, so I have to press on the...
Yeah, when you press on something, you can test it real quick. When you test on it, it gets crossed out and you can click it again to make it appear again.
Okay, so if it's like five things that are on,
if you get five in a row, specifically. You
get five in a row.
Poopy Lord is back.
It's vertical and horizontal, not diagonals.
Okay, so still, what do I get when I win?
Nothing. Great. Currently speaking, nothing, because I mean, I'm still on like the free war picture from you, but you know.
All right. Well.
Everybody, get your bingo cards ready. We're playing Dark Souls.
So what do we do?
Okay, there's a lot of places you can go now.
Yeah.
I'd say I hate all of them equally.
Great.
So. No, you cannot check off play Dark Souls because I haven't said it yet. No, where was I? Like, there are multiple places you can go right now.
Uh-huh.
So, hot take, I hate all of them, and I leave that up to you if you want to go the meme way or the difficulty way.
I guess meme sounds easier than difficult.
Yeah, then you have to drop down the hole in Majula.
The hole?
There are certain platforms you can jump down.
There's... what?
Just, yeah, the big-ass hole in the... like, there's a big-ass fucking hole.
That one, okay.
Okay, I'm going to change something off the fucking bingo card already.
Yeah, that hole, okay. I thought you were, like, down a well or something. That's force damage, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, but...
oh, God.
I think this is about there pretty much immediately.
I literally died from that.
Okay, great, so you can't do that yet. Good to know.
Then
you have to go the difficulty way. I'm apologizing. That doesn't count, because that's my fault.
That's what the fuck?
So, falling damage in Dark Souls 2 works, again, differently because they needed to change that. It's not percentage damage, it's flat damage, and it's based on your carry weight, but you're considering that you are on 30%.
Am I?
Yeah, but you should be at 40. Not 30, sorry.
49.
Yeah, roughly. That's alright. I mean, you can try to, literally... go jump down there naked, but I don't doubt that it will.
Nah, it's not worth it.
So the other way is, I fucking have to fucking west. Facing towards the lighthouse. I'm gonna call it a lighthouse. I know what I mean.
Uh-huh.
And to your left, there's a. To your far left, there's like an entryway that you went there once already.
Like the castle, the castle looking thing, okay.
Yeah. So this is the way that you went to the thing place, the Hydra's Fire Flame Tower, at the very beginning of the game, and now there's an NPC here. And I think you need to pay your money. So she can perform a miracle.
Why?
Because Dark Souls 2.
By item. Cleric no, Sacred like, Chime?
Yeah, it says move the path when you're just in the dialogue screen with her.
Oh. Just in the dialogue screen? Oh, there.
How much does it cost? I think 10,000.
2,000. Oh, thank God, 2,000. Thank God I have enough.
So, fun fact, if you just kill the NPC, you can do that for free.
Oh.
But it's not recommended to kill her because she's worth a certain degree.
That's a shame.
But, speedrunners just kill her because fuck it.
Yeah.
So, my favorite thing about this is literally she's like, I can perform a miracle. It's like, but you have to look away and you close your eyes and just press the button. Dark Souls 2.
Nice.
The message corridor, I forgot it was a thing. Like, whenever the Dark Souls 2, there's like a long patch with nothing happening, just like walking. Like, people just tend to spam messages that say, be wary of messages, messages ahead.
Which
are enemies, but messages.
Look at that, there's like an invisible wall here.
Yeah, but it's forced so you can fall down the cliff.
Yeah, that's
Dark Souls 2.
Why is that? That's so weird. Why would they put an invisible wall there? That's,
it'd be like that.
Yeah, we count that. Take that off.
Bescheid.
Don't forget on my card too, Tech.
Yeah, I keep my eyes on that.
Tech you.
I've got my eyes on... Okay, bad joke. Oh, it's a fucking weird guy! Forgot his name.
He's not interested in me.
Here's a fun thing about Souls 1 and 2. All the NPCs that are related to magic or like faith or something, they look at your stats, and if you don't have enough stats, they just don't talk to you. Like, here's the dark magic guy, and he looks at your faith and intelligence stats, like the total of that, and he's just like, nah, you're not good enough for that, fuck you.
Get out of my way, Scrub.
So, there's a lot of things going to be happening on this path, and I'm not entirely sure what all of that was.
I'm not sure if that's scenery or an enemy.
I think that's just like a thing. You can punch it, probably.
It's an enemy.
You can punch it, probably. It proceeds to punch it.
I mean, I wouldn't. Alright, into the... Okay, there's more things I can punch, but this time they have weapons. Be wary of punching.
Life gem! Poggers.
Pog gem.
Can we double tick bad joke?
If you double tick it, it's gone.
Who's vomiting here?
Yeah, actually, there's literally something vomiting. If you look up there somewhere, it should be like a giant butterfly.
Why was I correct about it? What the fuck? Maybe guess it poisons me.
Fun fact about it, when you kill all of them and go into New Game Plus, there is one merchant in Majula who sells armor pieces. And when you kill all of them and you're in their first place when you're in New Game Plus, he sells like a chest piece that's just butterfly wings.
Huh.
But it's chest open, so it's just running around topless with wings.
That's amazing, I want that.
It's Dark Souls 2.
Oh god. Oi lad! Fuck you.
Oi,
want?
Lad.
I don't think you can ever say oi lad again without thinking about that copypasta.
I didn't. Here's the hot take, but I don't
know about that. Again.
Okay. Here's a hot take, but I don't want to actually say the words because I don't want to give that free cross on the bingo card. But Lads was one of the possible fandom names of one of my favorites. Just say that.
Wait, what was?
I'm not saying those words. You're not getting that free tick.
Is it only if you talk about them?
No, anyone.
It specifically says Tech talks about.
Okay, so I can talk about this, no problem.
Yeah, and I can draw Vol, no problem. And
so, the thing was that... Wait, does it already count as interrupting?
There we go. Good, I can now interrupt your ass all I want.
But is it like, do we have to not do the things, or is it just, if it happens, it happens?
If it happens.
Yeah, if it happens, it happens, but
it's not a challenge, it's just...
It's a play-along thing.
After all, it's not like we win anything.
Where the fuck is it?
But I want to pat myself on the shoulder in one regard, is that for the entire life cycle of the PlayStation 4 that I owned one. What the fuck, whatever. For the entire life cycle of the PlayStation 4 that I have it, I've on Tuesday owned all varieties of the original normal PlayStation 4 controller. I had literally all the colors once at least.
Nice.
Also, voila.
Dying to bad gameplay, Emmett, means because someone misjudging a situation and being absolutely fucking retarded, like in Souls, when you run into 8 enemies at once. If you run into a trap that is not very obvious, then it doesn't count.
And drawing war, just to make it sure, was like just drawing.
Yeah, if Sepp gives drawing sounds.
Huh.
So if you hear...
No, that's destruction.
Von Cyrus' microphone. So I... No, just so you know, I have a drawing tablet, but I have it in my top drawer, so whenever I grab it, I just have to yank it out.
Also, when there is, like, accidental German, does that mean that when I...
It's accidental German.
But if I talk in it because I want to...
Then it's not accidental German.
You know what we could have also added? The war?
The war?
The war?
Yeah, I need to add war and, Pekin not finding the way.
Yeah! Or him being annoyed because things aren't laid out for colorblind people.
Honestly. Yeah, there's some improvements made there. Remove some of the free spaces and add some of that stuff.
No, he will just add more later on.
Oh. No. The fuck? A 5x5 grid was already a pain in the ass. I would need to add 11 more to make a new bingo grid.
Good.
I guess if we come up with enough.
Besides that, the page I use only supports up to 5x5.
Oh. Tis a shame.
God. Fuck, I'm stupid.
Bye.
Oh yeah, burping.
No, typing sound is specifically meant towards, like, when somebody looks something up and you can very clearly hear them typing, for example.
Yeah, that's probably directed to my keyboard because it's loud as fuck.
That's probably directed to me because I type loud as shit and my microphone is literally, like, 2 centimeters above that.
I have a question, like, I'm just going to make my style of typing, like, can you hear that?
What do you mean, can yeah, I you use can bonfire?
Okay.
Who the fuck is here?
That doesn't count, it was an example.
Who the fuck is here? What do you mean cannot use? Oh, I mean, hello there.
Oi, laddies!
Oi, lass!
Can't. You sure look like a wee bit of fun if you ask me, eh?
In it?
She grabs me by the arm and pulls me to the bathroom.
Yay. I mean, kinda hot, not gonna lie.
Yeah, for fuck's sake, Emma is right.
What?
Your assholes agreed on being, on agreeing that the board could be bigger. Where is it? There. No, that does not count as talking about porn. We're, like, actually talking about porn. I'm not being triggered by that, you fucking asshole. No, I am!
Wait, so we have two things now?
Fuck this game!
No, that's for me, that's for me!
I can't speak, fuck.
Fuck this game is for me.
By the way. Fuck this game is a pure PK quote.
It's a pure rage quote when the game literally pisses me off so hard. Who the fuck is that? Mr. Big Scythe guy?
That's not a scythe, that's a sickle.
Bill Nye, the scythe guy.
Yes. Oh my god, you could have also added, like, rolling damage.
Nah.
When I take damage from rolling, and I get pissed by that.
I wanted to make it, like, a genuine new gaming, not just Dark Souls.
Oh yeah, okay.
Yeah, fuck this game, only counts on PK, says that.
Obviously. Oh, Dark Spirit, what? Why?
Hold on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why?
What? Fun fact, technically speaking, the Fallon is a bug.
What? Why?
Because the idea was, when you are embered in Dark Souls 3, for example, then you're a multiplayer, just so people can help you. But there should be this cross connection that people can also, like, I fucking hate you. Yeah, there were drinking sounds. fucking hell.
We already had those.
No.
And we did? I don't fucking care. We just had
I opened the fucking can of Rockstar.
We had never one had heard that.
You even said, like, yeah, we have the eating or drinking sounds.
What?
No.
You even said that.
No.
What?
When? What?
I think Sarah was having a stroke.
The fuck are you all about?
The can you said that?
I mean, we literally have to stream archive to check this later, just so you know. No, anyways, the idea is, like, when you play multiplayer, then you can get invaded by people, but you also can be helped by other people. and I wanted that to be the balancing of it. But I realized that there were a lot of places in Dark Souls 1 that people were not invading, because fuck those areas. So they added a lot more invaders in Dark Souls 2, and specifically the Forlorn, who can pretty much invade you everywhere. But they fucked up some bit of coding, so you can also invade you when you're not embered.
Great.
And then just never fixed it, because I was like, ah, fuck. It adds to the game, I guess.
I think I outran- nope, I don't think I outran him, because there's still any- oh my god.
No, you cannot outran him, run him. He will always know where you are.
Why?
That's normal Dark Souls NPC things.
Okay, fair enough, but still it's dumb. Oh my this, god.
This does not constitute as a fuck this game already, just so you know.
No, I'm just confused. And
the bar that currently filled up is the curse bar, by the way.
Yeah, I'm dead. Hey, yeah, Forlorn, what's up? Okay, at least he should despawn now and not bother me for a while.
No, there's no capping with how often he can invade you.
Yeah, but it's random, right?
Yeah.
Then I
but
hope.
There's still a good chance that he could still just invade you again. No, do we count this as bad gameplay? I think I need to actually remove that, because that is too
vague. It's vague, but the thing is, I was just trying to get further. It's not like I was trying to survive too much, I was just seeing where to go.
Oh yeah, by the way, PK, just so you know, like, the whole place that you are right now is the bone zone.
Awesome.
Because every soul has a bone zone. There was something I wanted to say right now, besides the fall zone thing. Oh yeah, the curse thing. In Dark Souls 3, the curse was a one-hit thing. I think I told you that.
Mm-hmm.
In this game, it's not. Because they made... What curse is in Dark Souls 1 and 3 is petrified in this game. And this game, curse is a different debuff. And what it does is, when it fills up, it counts, technically speaking, as you dying with, like, the maximum HP drop thing.
Eh?
When you die in this game, you lose max HP.
Yeah.
You see that with the leftover bar.
Yeah.
When you get cursed, it will count as you dying once towards that bar.
Why?
But you didn't die. And there was, like, a big-ass debate. It's like, Dark Souls, don't have the bonfire runs. How does this count? And just so you know, it doesn't count. No, definitely not by runs.
So it's also no curse run.
Yeah, no, it doesn't. In the sense of, it does not count towards the death.
Oh,
that's
okay.
What I meant.
Okay.
Because in Dark Souls 2, you get reward when you beat the game without using a bonfire and beating it without dying, and you still get them even when you got cursed.
Okay. I'm just going a totally different direction now, I don't know why.
I don't... honestly, can I be 100% true with you?
Yeah.
I don't think I've beaten this area.
Oh, so like, it's optional?
No, it is mandatory, but I think I glitched my way through it.
How?
Yeah, because there's two bosses in this area. One boss in this area, really. The other one is technically in the next area already. And as far as I know, it's not optional, but I just never beaten it.
Oh, that makes sense.
So, by the way, you're literally heading straight to that boss when I was talking to. Oh yeah, there are holes in that bridge. Dark Souls 2. I only need to left click PK.
bad gameplay.
It do be like that.
Oh, there we go.
We already had that.
Yes. We already had that. Yes.
Had that?
Yes.
When?
In the beginning, like instantly almost.
I mean, it's not. We should our fault with PK if people don't pay attention.
Wait, so we don't have to announce that if it happens. So if it happens, we just have to put it in there.
I mean, it would be nice to announce it, because then everyone has it.
Yeah, but that's a DF bingo. Like, it's your fault if you didn't cross that out.
Oh.
By the way, there's an enemy in this area that literally does nothing.
I love it.
Like, it's a normal hollow enemy. To be more exact, a torch hollow without a torch. But he is coded to lure you into enemies. He does not attack you. But if there are no enemies around, he just runs around in circles.
My favorite kind of enemy.
It's so fucking retarded. I really hope that you get to the funhouse today.
Oh, oh.
Is it the one with the Glubgogapgalap?
Yeah, the Glubgogapgalap.
Glubgogapgalap.
Pig's like, what the fuck are you guys talking about?
Shout out to Glubgogapgalap.
You have no idea what we're talking about, do you?
Why would I?
It's a children's Christian movie by an independent Polish movie maker called Stroganowski and the something house. I think, forget what it was. And it's like a musical thing, like there's songs every now and then. And there was one creature called the Glubgogapgalap, who is like a big slug, like man, like human slug kind of thing, who eats the knowledge from books. And he, when he first appears, he has like a small song that he sings about himself. And he's like, I am the Glubgogapgalap, the Schwabble Dabble 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 Fibo Dabble Dabble.
Okay, Rick. Rick and Mortimer.
It does sound like a fucking Rick and Morty thing.
Boy.
I love it.
Okay, let's try crossing the bridge again and not dying.
By the way, the whole movie is on YouTube. It's like 14 minutes long and it's the fucking worst.
Oh, wait. Is it like super shitty animated?
Yeah.
I think I know what you're talking about.
Is that thing you were thinking about, like,
what is PK? Man
being fat?
Yeah, what? Like a really fat piece of shit thing.
It's like just like book stands in the background.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a Glubgogapgalap.
Oh my god.
Oh, yeah.
Oh yeah, by the way, PK, just so you know, there's an Esther shot we missed.
Cool.
What the? Yeah, there's always an invader shitting in front of us through the door.
Why?
Dark Souls 2.
Why?
Honestly, I have no fucking idea why.
Why would you do that?
Like, it's not even an invader officially, it's just an enemy that looks like an invader.
Is it a one-time enemy or is it always?
I don't fucking know, I've never beaten this thing.
Okay.
Like, right behind this invader dude is the boss arena, this is literally a boss that I've never beaten.
Oh. Then why am I supposed to beat the boss?
I don't know, you're heading this way constantly.
Yeah, where should I go then?
I don't fucking know.
Oh.
It sucks us too! Like, and the fuck do I know where I have to go?
Should do this as well as a bingo thingy.
Not knowing where to go.
Like, where do I have to go from PK? And this is Dark Souls.
Nah, the thing is, as I said, I wanted to be too, like, game unspecific.
Yeah.
So when I say, like, when PK is playing here, I cannot say, this is Dark Souls. It doesn't work like this.
You already did things like that.
Shut up.
No.
Getting to the boss over and over again is gonna be a fucking chore, I think.
Don't worry, it's one of the more liked bosses of this game, as far as I know.
Yeah, but getting there is gonna drain me of my resources, probably.
Do we count that as wasting your items?
Well, no, I didn't waste them yet.
Yeah, no.
It's more like a thing of, I don't know what buttons to press because I'm used to another game.
Yeah, imagine playing another game instead of Dark Souls.
Which was more of a problem when I played Code Vein still. Because that control scheme is totally different.
I'm just gonna go, like, boot up my normal character and have a look around at this place and tell you how you have to go.
How I have to go?
Shut up!
Put your left foot in, put your right foot out.
I don't know the other words to shake it all around.
No, that's the Hokey Pokey, not the shake it all around.
Well, isn't it?
No, it's the Hokey like Pokey.
And that's what it's all about?
I don't know.
Because I 100% remember that they shake it all around and they rhyme it to it's all about. That's something that I 100% remember.
But how would I know?
You started singing it, you fucking asshole!
No, I didn't.
Does that count as vibing?
Shut up!
There's no way I can even enter the fog gate. That dude almost one hits me.
Yeah, but Dark Souls 2, by the way, you don't have iframes when
I know. That's why I'm saying that. I can't get there.
Just making sure that this is something you have in mind.
Yeah, I can't get there. Well, fuck that. Fuck that boss. Not gonna do that boss.
So it does count as lighting.
What?
No, why, we aren't, I don't. I wouldn't count this as vibing because neither of us were vibing.
We aren't vibing. I'm I'm blowing my brains out over this.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not. It's apparently it's not necessary to go through there.
Good.
Look, according to the, you know.
Do it.
According to the. Is this to play Bone Dust here? What the fuck? That's something we need to get.
Like hell, I'm gonna explore this area right now.
Like, no, it's a. Hey, horse appears!
Oh!
Hey, time for that part of the bingo.
Hello, respectable humans and Emmet.
Hello, Horst. How you doing?
Probably horsting around.
Horsting around at the speed of sound.
At the speed of Horst.
Got places to horse, gotta follow my rainbow.
Gotta follow my armet. That was worthwhile.
So now my cat is screaming again. Good job. Okay, okay, yeah.
Right, so that bone cave doesn't help me any, because there's just a dead end.
I think that's shortcut later there.
Maybe, but I don't know.
I mean, it's Dark Souls 2, so, you know. My memories are fading about this game, and I really don't mind.
I thought it was a good game.
It is. It is still the second best Dark Souls.
That's not saying much if there's only three.
First, yeah, I like the first one.
Forlorn, go away! What a mood.
I mean, everybody's entitled to bad opinions.
So are you.
How the fuck do you get in there?
I got you in there!
Yeah, it's just an open fucking door. Okay, great. I don't fucking remember jack shit about this place.
Guess I'll take the bridge then. Not gonna help me though, because Forlorn is gonna kick my ass sooner or later.
Just before that drawbridge thing. Yeah, I think you know what I mean.
The bridge I activated, you mean?
Yeah, there was a lever in the house, I think that was
the... That's for the bridge.
Okay, good. That was I wanted to ask, like, what was that for?
Yeah, that's the bridge, don't worry. A key! Oh, a key in a area where nothing happened. Okay. Thanks for... You know what? Huh? I got a key that's good enough for this adventure.
I fucking remember what that key is for. I think in like the... When you just cross the first bridge to the open area, there's like one blocked thing, and I think there's an important item in there somewhere.
Hmm.
But as I said, it's access to my memories are fading about this game.
So the thing is, I got a key, but I don't know where to use it, so... I am confused. Guess I'll just wander around aimlessly again, trying to find something and keep dying.
Oh well, I can actually tell you now. let me just backtrack a bit so I can tell you where you have for you have to start the best. So after you pass that drawbridge, there's a second bridge to your left.
Yeah, that's the one where I got the key from.
Yeah, if you hold yourself to the left wall and just continue, then there's a way you can walk, and I think that leads directly to the boss that continues the game.
Okay, let's see if I can.
Which is it?
I'm not gonna tell you, fuck. Because telling the name would immediately spoil everything about the boss.
Oh, okay, then I won't. I probably have a hunch right now.
Just have like some. Okay.
No,
just
if I keep holding left, that's where I found the key. That's not the right way.
Just continue on.
Well, no, I'm currently being invaded again, so no.
literally, that's the way you have to go.
Oh. No, that's a cliff that's gonna kill me. Yeah. No, that's the enemy that's gonna... Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Literally
that way you have to go. And just continue on and you will get to the boss room. And if you don't, I mean, you go into the boss room, but turn to the right a bit more, then there's a shortcut somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Also, that drop is for damage again, so that's lovely.
Stax has two, that just happens in this game.
It's annoying.
I guess. Not that bad. Because that's like...
Go away.
Close to nothing, realistically.
Every bit counts.
And you can technically make the jump towards the platform and then drop from there. Then you take literally no damage. You can make that jump, don't giggle about that.
Yeah, I can't.
That's your fault.
Yes.
Fault.
Gorge.
Go away, go. Okay, don't go away then. It's fun how the enemies just wall you.
Yeah, that sucks too for you.
And how the bows always hit you sometimes, for no reason.
Yeah, that's just Dark Souls for you.
Go away! Stupid dark spirit! Go away! Oh, I made a jump, cool. Well, in that and case, let me drink.
If you continue,
oh, dude, okay.
So before you jump down.
Oh.
Did you jump down already?
Yes.
Okay, good.
I mean, there's just nothing there.
Just continue on with the behind the waterfall.
Uh-huh.
If you turn.
Because behind the waterfall is a secret.
Yeah, no, that's a boss fight.
And behind the waterfall, there's something else. There's a cave.
Yeah, this leads to a shortcut. Because the first thing behind the waterfall is the boss fight. I don't remember jack shit about this place.
Because there was like... Oh, yeah, this shortcut is not gonna help me because I'm getting... I have a feeling the shortcut is not gonna be of use. Because I can't even lock it. Like, that just leads into the skeleton cave, which also is a problematic place. Because I can't get through there. So, yeah. Pretty fucked, am I?
I honestly don't think the skeleton cave is the worst choice here.
I mean, I'm getting walled either way by everything, so...
There's like three skeletons in that cave.
There's more than that.
Literally killing him right now. I'm on the fourth right now and I don't see him. Fifth. Okay, there's the fifth one. There are five skeletons here. I don't know what about your damage, but I two-shot them with a dagger, so...
Yeah, I think I two-shot them, but still, my stamina.
Yeah, okay, good. Yeah, actually, you think we have the same stamina.
Go away, dude.
I have 26 points in endurance, I think we have the same stamina. But anyways, you know the way to the boss now.
Let's see if that does me any good.
Gonna say things out loud. I doubt that you will enjoy that boss, but
cool.
For the meme you will.
Oh my god, why is the dark spirit now appearing all the time? Go away.
I'm certain which one
this is Merciless Rowena. This is if you're always getting invaded by the same NPC, like NPC and not the Forlorn, then this is hard scripted.
Yeah, but the first time I went there, I didn't get invaded.
Yeah, because the Fallen was still in your world, currently.
Oh. Okay, I didn't know there couldn't... I didn't know there could be only one.
It's at least my best guess, by the way. Okay. I should emphasize.
Right, let's quickly find the way through the skeleton cave. No, that's not anything. Let's go. Pull the lever! Pull it! I said go! Come on! The fucking dark spirit is... I can't pull the lever!
Yeah.
Come on!
Why am I glowing?
Well, let's spend 20 attempts to pull the lever and then not get anything done.
if you're gonna complain about it, you can also just head to the boss. It's your opinion, which the easier way is. I just say,
if it's a shit boss, I'd rather... Like, either way sounds shit, because... See, the thing is, if I just go normally to the boss, I'm gonna always have the fucking dark spirit on my ass. If I try to unlock this skeleton cave, then I have to first of all deal with the dark spirit in close quarters and get walled by everything. So either way, it's total shit.
Hot take? Keep in mind that Dark Souls is not a run-through-it game. You can most definitely get rid most of the enemies on your way to the Dark Spirit, and then try your best to 1v1 it.
No.
Yes.
Because it's not happening, because that thing is too strong for me.
Yeah, that's the case of all invaders in Dark Souls 2 too. Mm-hmm. But something you should know is of the NPC invaders, they don't heal.
Ah, okay.
So what they have in health is what they have in health.
Okay.
I think only the Fallen heals, because he's an asshole.
Obviously.
PK, we just constantly saying in chat, say the thing, PK, say the thing.
I'm trying to be a nice boy today. Keyword trying. If the game pisses me off too much, I can't
okay,
try.
Okay, we count that as PK doubting himself.
What do you mean?
Keyword is I'm trying.
It's more so I'm doubting the game here.
Wait, does it count as PK downing himself?
I don't care.
Okay, pull the lever. Quick. Pull it! Pull it! Come on. Okay, heal at least. Come on. Heal.
Also, at what point
kill
do bounce, you
kill
say he's triggered?
Kill a bounce.
Someone was already triggered, yeah.
He was already triggered?
How can
I was
do
already
that?
Triggered. Just as someone.
You can't do that!
When were you triggered?
You literally can't do that!
Because Emmett was keeping, saying stuff like, so that's happening. I'm like, no, it's not. I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm being triggered right now.
You literally can't do that.
That's why I reminded you that trying to slowly beat that is a thing.
But I can't because there's too many enemies.
Yes, yeah, but there are so few, what's the word for that? Like, not the English word, but the wording of the idiom.
What?
There's not few and far between, but there's a lot of space between all the enemies. You can definitely take them one by one.
Yeah, that's gonna take forever, and I'm gonna die on one of the later ones, and then I'm gonna get pissed.
Yeah, and then that's just the case. That would equally piss you off as just keep running into it and constantly dying. At least you don't, with one you have a soul. We get some souls out of it.
Well, not really, because if I died again, then
they're just gonna lie there, and you're gonna run there up to them and pick that up.
No. Because I'll die earlier, and then I'm gonna get extra pissed because I lose all my souls.
Yeah. And then it'd just be like that sometimes.
And then I get... And then I can't move. And, yeah. Do you... You see that shit?
Yeah, but you can...
What you can? Tell me.
Yeah, I can definitely tell you what you can, but you're not listening to me, your ass. Kill them before they get you.
Fine, I'll do that. Fine, let's see how well that goes for me.
Yeah.
Gonna waste all my fucking resources on those fuckers then.
Oh yeah, you mean the Estes that don't get wasted?
I mean the life gems if I run out of Estes.
Yeah, you have 4 Estes, that won't be happening that fast.
Uh-huh.
You can combo one, you can infinite combo pretty much all of these enemies except for the fat sickle guy.
Uh-huh. And that fat sickle guy is the main problem, I think.
Yeah, at max you should be wasting one or two Estes on him. Also, keep in mind, the shield is a thing.
Once again, I hate the shield.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep telling you it until you learn that, by the way.
Implying I ever learn anything. I'm not a good Dark Souls player, obviously, so... I think we've already established that, like, ages ago.
Nah, really not.
Why?
Because in Dark Souls 3, you actually made it pretty well.
Not really? Like, 300 plus deaths, that's not well.
That's pretty well.
And I'm poisoned.
Considering that you did, poisoning in Dark Souls 2 is incredibly quick.
Also saying that you, like, that was your first Dark Souls you played?
And you've beaten all the DLC, more or less, all the DLC bosses. Including Gale, which is hands down one of the more difficult bosses from the game series.
Oh, so the poison never stops, cool.
It stops.
didn't notice.
Yeah, because the bar was still going.
Cool. It's gonna be a long night.
I know. At least there will be progress.
I kinda doubt that.
Click.
Yep. That one was a given, but I honestly, seriously doubt that.
Oh, PK, you're pretty close, to getting a bingo here. But the thing is, we established already that this is something that is too vague to actually click, so, sadly. You won't be dying too bad by the gameplay, because that's way too vague. I just realized that I'm pretty close to getting a bingo to the degree that I can just do that by saying three measly words.
Three measly words? What would that be then?
This fucking poison butterfly. Go away.
You can just literally walk out of its range.
Yeah, but I don't even know what its range is, so.
You can see it, but it's giant ass green fucking pollen glow. But also PK in the area right behind the first bridge, there's a house that you can enter. There's an item there that you really want.
Do I?
Yeah, it's sublime bone dust. It increases the strength of your Estus.
Oh.
There's still an Estus shot we have to get.
Yeah, we'll get to that. Ow. Fucking dog. So like after the drawbridge or?
Yeah, before the drawbridge, after the first normal bridge.
The thing is, I looked to all the houses and most of them were just totally locked, so.
There's probably an entrance you just didn't see. It's not me complaining about you being shit, but it's just like I also struggle with it for some reason. It's pretty hard to see in this place.
I mean, I thought I went to all the sides of the houses.
Also could be that I'm wrong, but I think it was somewhere there. Can just look it up real quick.
Cause yeah, there's all those gates around the fucking thing, so there's no way to get in.
From the front as well? Man.
What constitutes as a front?
A lot.
On a circular building with four equal.
So let me just look up where the item is, actually.
Oh.
What the fuck? What the actual fuck is this?
Now
I just looked up where it is.
Yay, time waster! Woo, I died because of this enemy. Woohoo! Woohoo! So, what did you look up?
Where the item is actually, so I'm just gonna look up if I can find it quickly.
Then I can't. So you're saying I can't get it yet, or?
You can get it yet, it's just looking up where this actually is so I can. Lead you a bit better.
Time to kill every single enemy again, so they can kill me later.
PK, stop complaining, this is the game.
I can still complain.
I mean, I can only just tell you to stop complaining, I can't stop you physically, so.
Yeah, because you're not here.
So, when is the night next time you're heading over to PK?
I don't know, maybe next year sometime?
My fat ass will tag along and beat him.
Well, right.
You will tag along?
Most definitely will tag along to beat him.
The thing is, that would make the train, or whatever the fuck I go with,
imagine,
way more easier to live through.
Live through?
Wait. I don't think that he will really do this.
I don't mind.
Yeah, but where will you sleep, though?
I have an attic.
I don't mind.
You have an attic?
Obviously.
Alright. But would your fam be...
Yeah, it's a fucking bonfire! What?
What?
After the drawbridge is a bonfire.
What?
In one of the locked houses. There's a house and I guess it's locked.
Well,
I guess that's
what's the point of that then?
I don't like. I have it open. Is what I'm saying.
Yeah, you. But
yeah, there's a good chance that you already have that key. Because then you have a key and you don't know where to use it.
First of all, I have to find the house.
That's it's the... right behind the broad drawbridge. You can literally immediately see that. Like, to the right of the skeleton cave.
Both of you to skeleton cave?
Yeah.
No, the skeleton cave right... isn't on the job.
What? Not the skeleton, but fuck the fuck was the cave now? No, that is the skeleton cave.
No, is it?
It is the skeleton cave. Like, right in front of you when you cross the bridge. Also, keep in mind, PK, that when you actually fight enemies here, you get used to the mechanics a bit better, considering that the game is pretty unique.
To say the least.
I mean, actually, when we say it this way, all of the Souls games are unique, therefore, because none of them played similar.
Okay, that cuts out a few fat guys, at least.
Yeah. That actually makes, I think, two or three of the people that would chase you normally not chase you anymore. I still need to figure out where the fuck the sublime bonus is.
Nowhere and everywhere. It's a myth, it never existed.
I hate this place. Okay, wait, that's not the Skull of the First Edition. I was really complaining right now.
Wait, is there a difference in item place?
Yeah, there is a difference.
Oh my god, why?
They changed a lot of things that were shitty.
Oh.
So the Sublime Bone Dust used to be right in front of the one boss arena where the one invader stands in front of the boss gate. And to get to that, you would have to literally do a jump across a pit.
Why?
Dark Souls 2.
I should stop questioning these things and just accept them.
Just stop then.
Why?
Stop complaining then. Don't ask.
Merciless Rona, let's go. See if we can actually fight you.
Fucking man. Okay, yeah, no, I figured it out, PK. Can tell you where the Sublime Bone Master is now.
Why is there a poison thing here too? God, these things are annoying.
I think it can also poison them. It's like just an area effect.
I mean, that would be cool if that were the thing, but I don't know if the game is that nice.
No, it's an area effect, it should, but I don't know if it counts for invaders, because invaders, generally speaking, have interesting rules in this game. They really wanted to make invading seem more like a rewarding thing for the invader, so they really changed up some things.
Invader banished. Does that mean she never spawns again, or...?
I guess. That's what that imply.
That would be cool!
So, Pika, you wanna pick the Sublime Bone Dust up real quick? Because I can tell you where you have to go.
Okay...
It's in front of the drawbridge.
Not
behind of it.
So, on the side where you were before you crossed it.
Yeah. When you crossed back now, from the way you're coming now, when you hold left and look down the cliffs, you can see that you can drop it down into one of the houses. There's a hole in the roof. And in there is the bone dust.
I was kind of thinking I could drop into one of the houses somehow, but I wasn't sure how.
So just so you know, just when you cross a bridge, hold left. And you look down and you see that somewhere.
To the left.
Considering you're not gonna do that one boss with the invader right in front of us.
Yeah, it is.
Soul
Spear! No, that's not the right thing! Go away!
No, it should be the right thing, because there's one more item in there.
No, there's a chest! Oh, god!
Yes, two more items in there, then. Great.
Oh, boy.
I get used to these big shield spear guys. They are pretty common enemies in this game.
Yeah, I'm so dead. Oh, god. Where's that dog now?
Oh, fun fact, Limit Breakers, one of the Dark Souls YouTubers who does a lot of like statistics and knowledge things, made a video the other day, today or yesterday, that the dogs in Dark Souls 3, they teleport.
Oh. They are bone dust, fucking hell.
So they're the big dogs, they have the issue, or the way that Dark Souls 3 it works? I don't think the other... I don't fucking care.
What do you mean hurrah for shortcut? That's not a shortcut. Idiot. You know what? I'm rating this message.
Dislike.
I would rate the message if Who is shooting arrows at me at this precise angle? Fuck off.
Raid plus one and
two. Raid.
Like, so much as raid.
What do you mean I can't?
Yeah, you rated for it.
Oh, so I can't dislike it.
Yeah, it's dislike. Yeah.
Why?
I rated it.
That's dumb.
Yeah, I don't fucking know. I mean, it was a unique concept, so even that we had that was already interesting.
I guess, but if you put a rating system, put dislikes, for fuck's sake. Now I accidentally liked this message. I'm pissed.
So anyways, considering you're not going to do that one boss of the invader in front of it, because fuck that boss and it's unnecessary, that would be the undead chariot.
Okay.
Oh, that thing it was. Okay,
I just wanted to show
do I have enough souls to level up a bit?
Yeah, go to Majora because the sublime bone dust.
Yeah, that too.
So the Under Chariot would be like one big circular arena, like a racetrack, and there would be just constantly be one big ass chariot driving down it.
Oh, like that boss in Kid Icarus Uprising. Except you're not on a chariot.
Yeah, but you have to imagine that the chariot is just as big as the course itself, so there's really no dodging.
Okay, and then like one level up, great.
Endurance, I guess.
Yeah.
Or Vigor.
Yeah, Viagra, let's go. No, wait. Let's go for Viagra. Why not?
So anyways, you would have to go through like a kind of like an obstacle course. Not like a jump and run, but more like get to the next cover quickly enough while skeletons are attacking you.
Uh-huh.
And in the end, you would pull a lever to drop like a gate on the chariot so it doesn't ride anymore. And then you can actually fight the boss. It's one of the more liked ones because it's like, it's challenging, it's rather difficult actually, but it's a gimmicky and it's actually pretty fun.
Huh.
But I never beaten it because fuck that invader dude in front of it.
It reminds me of God, or whatever the one from Majora's Mask was called.
Yeah, kinda.
Oh yeah!
Majora's Mask was a thing.
It actually was. Even though it was a fever dream.
Fun fact, I've never actually beaten that game.
Neither have I.
I always played to the moon, but then just something happened that I couldn't continue playing.
What happened?
Well, I never owned the original, it's a big surprise. I never owned the GameCube thing, big surprise.
So, 3DS version?
Yeah, I played it on emulator, and I just...
Oh.
You know, my PC broke.
Oh, okay.
And then I borrowed the 3DS version of a friend, and he wanted to have that back. And I couldn't beat it in the last the game back, and I couldn't beat it in that day because my DS actually is kind of broken-ish in the regard that my L button doesn't work anymore.
I gotta say though, Majora's Mask stresses me out.
Yeah, the timer really
ticks
me the wrong way.
I mean, yeah, it's unique and stuff, but I'm not a fan.
It really doesn't tickle my fancy, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Actually,
I like the feeling of it.
Yeah.
It gets the feeling of despair and shit across, but at the same time it's like, I don't wanna be on a fucking time loop for the whole game.
You know the grief theory about Majora's Mask, don't you guys?
Yep, it's bullshit.
I like it.
I like it as well, but it's bullshit.
Why is it bullshit?
Because MadPat made it.
Yeah, but...
He didn't make it, he just took it from someone on Reddit.
Honestly, I think it's an absolute solid theory.
Wait.
The Skeleton Lords!
A triple boss!
Oh, actually no. That was the one I thought.
Actually no. You would see. It's more than a triple.
Oh baby, a quadruple.
Oh baby, a triple.
Yeah.
Okay, imagine if it would only be four. By the way, this is the bone zone, just so you know.
Yeah, I figured as much, but oh my god.
Like whenever there's like a guide YouTuber or one of these .exe YouTubers or meme YouTubers in Dark Souls 2 community, whenever they hear, they always play like some xylophone song for obvious reasons.
Spooky, scary. Oh, I should have played this on Halloween. But you guys weren't there.
I mean, technically I was a terrorist and Cyrus has a microphone.
Yeah, but you guys were having party and I was not, so...
We're having a party. I've been told that I smell like cheese. And I've been having an absolute stroke in PlayStation VR. That sounds like a party. So, PK, you're already enjoying the Skeleton Lords.
I mean, if I am only fighting one of them, it's fine, but, well, let's see if anything happens if I kill one of them. Well, he's burning and exploding. Shooting shrapnel everywhere. Okay, that's cool. So I'm guessing they're like elementally... Oh! Do the goons count towards the health bar of the boss?
I think they do.
Oh.
Like, if I'm not mistaken, you have to kill them so the boss dies. I don't know if they count for the... I don't know if they count for that, though. Yeah, they do.
Oh.
Skeleton lords. So each time you kill one of them, they spawn eight skeletons, I think, or seven. And depending on which one you kill, they are different skeletons.
Okay, I have a tactic. Whittle them all down at them. Actually, that would... No, that would be enemy spam 10,000.
Yeah.
Okay.
Death count increased.
Then I have no idea what tactic to use.
The only tactic that I really use for this fight is that I know that skeletons are weak to strike damage, so I swap to a mace. That was about it.
It's annoying how I always have to waste an Estus or two on the way there.
I guess you can just waste one.
It's not very good.
It's not the same. But honestly, currently you have... You mean, yeah, first try on the boss doesn't give a good sample size. But I would only complain about these things if you actually use all your Estus and then some. So, like, if you don't get to heal anyways, then it really doesn't matter that much.
Okay.
And considering that Dark Souls 2's Estus are weird. I don't want to say they're bad, because Dark Souls 1's Estus were bad.
Bestus.
Yeah, they were the worstest.
Oh.
Can we double cross bad jokes?
Should be triple crossed at this rate. Oh. I mean, at least they die quickly enough on their own, but the army is gonna be the problem. Also that they shoot ranged shit.
Picky, you wanna know something fun?
Picky? Like pickle Picky. Juice.
You wanna know something fun, Picky?
No.
There are people that beat this game without even taking damage.
Yep, that's true.
Yeah, that's not me.
Taking damage equals resetting the game.
Are you kidding me? Oh yeah, wasn't that one guy who marathoned like all the Dark Souls games and then if he took damage he had to reset to the total beginning? What a mad lad.
And he did all DLCs, so he did it until Gale.
What a fucking mad lad. Did he actually finish that run eventually?
Yeah,
or?
He did.
Wow.
He did.
Mad respect.
But, there's just so fucking money skeletons.
You cannot escape the bone zone.
Like, honestly, I want to be mad about the game design, but it's just so fucking fun.
Like, it's funny. I have to agree, it's funny. But
you see what I mean with that being a meme? That you will dislike the boss, but you will love it for the meme.
Like, it's shitty design. It's totally shitty design, but...
Like, it sucks, but you cannot help but
it's
to like
hilarious.
It for some reason.
Like, you just got all these Mr. Bones attacking you.
And the floor's bones, and the walls are bones, everything is bones.
You get bones, you get bones, you get bones, everyone gets bones.
Ah, come to the bones!
Okay, I think I'm gonna be able to take out another one of the big guys again. See, the thing is, once I take out all the three big guys, I only have to deal with goons, and that should be fine, right?
Depends. Like, I personally speaking, I'm way worse with large quantities of enemies. And I play greatswords, which is like the weapon that counters that, actually.
Ah.
So, it depends. As I said, I don't prefer that. Anyways, keep in mind, as I said, each skeleton lords has their own kinds of skeleton they spawn. Just so you know.
Yeah.
So the first one you killed was the weaker skeleton ones, the second one is the armored skeleton ones.
Ah.
They move a bit slower, but, you know, they take a bit more damage.
They take three hits from me, so...
Yeah. And the last one, well, let's just say, I don't think you've ever fought these enemies in Soulspawn, and they're one of the most notoriously cheesy-ass enemies in the entire Soul series.
What do you mean cheesy?
You will see.
Okay, so I only got this guy, let's do a one-on-one then, bitch.
Come on, fight me, you asshole.
Oh, he takes a lot of damage, oh god.
Yeah, he's a magician one.
Yeah, the mage is a weak bitch. So, now I'm getting mage skeletons or what?
You will see.
Is it cheesy in a good or bad sense?
Bad.
Oh no. Oh no, the wheels, no!
The wheels!
I fought the wheels! Why, how can I backstab a wheel skeleton? Oh, only two wheels?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you kill this one first, it's like the worst thing like of all time.
So, I unintentionally did it in a good tactic.
Yeah.
Cool.
I don't know where I have to head now. Where's the bonfire destructions too? But I think there's like a different way out in this boss room somewhere.
I just see the crackling of bones everywhere. I'm like, oh god. Is this the way out? Looks like it. I didn't go here. Let's hope there's no enemies.
Yeah, that's the way out. I think there should be a bonfire coming soon.
I'm scared. Okay, there's a lever.
You're heading to the funhouse now, if I'm not mistaken. By the way, this is technically speaking the area that you know, but I will get to that when I get to that.
Okay. So how did I do?
I guess it was good. I like the phantom walking across the air.
Yeah, good boy.
He's a good boy. I mean, that two or three tries, I didn't count. I think three.
No, that was no, two. Two. It's my second try. The first one was just the case of what the fuck is happening, so...
But you get what I mean with the...
I can rarely count first tries in Dark Souls, because I'm mostly in the, oh god, what's happening, mindset.
Yeah, but you can definitely agree on the fact that this is a fun boss.
It's funny. That's a good ladder.
Yeah.
Fucking point of no return here.
Where's my
bonfire? Please, I want the bonfire.
To your right somewhere. Behind the cart, I think.
Harvest Valley.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, through the poison swamp. Great. Yeah.
Get used to mandatory poisoning. Welcome to fucking Dark Souls.
What the fuck is that?
The green body!
Why?
We'll pick a head back to Majula.
Yeah,
maybe.
I was gonna. Why so, is that...
In Dark Souls 2, they were like, you know what? We had liquids that poison you, but we didn't do that logically. When you walk through these liquids that poison you, they will stick to you. So even if you leave that now, you will still get poisoned. So yeah, level up and then I guess you can try to get that one essence we missed, I think.
I guess.
So level up and then go to the Cardinal Tower in...
Okay, I got three level ups.
Powers of the Giants.
I guess I want some in stamina and...
I would put something in...
Adaptability or...?
Strength, I think. Strength? I would do it. Like, there's a stat that says... Like, on the very far right, it says R weapon 1. Put 1 point in attack and then in dex. Strength and dex and look which increases it more. Not attunement, dex and strength.
Dex doesn't increase it at all.
Yeah, then you have a strength weapon. I wasn't sure about that. Like, you should slowly get a bit more damage out, I think.
Okay, so I guess I'll put some in... I put two in strength and one in adaptability, because I need more adaptability, I guess.
Keith, I was talking to Keith today about, you getting a bit further into the game today again.
Uh-huh.
And asking him for some opinions. And he told me that he prefers to stay at 16 adaptability.
Oh.
And I'm just like, why do you have a favorite level stats in Souls 2? What the fuck is wrong with you?
Like, what's the point of staying at a lower level than...
No death, no bonfire runs, you don't get a level. Well, you do, but rarely.
Okay, but that does not apply to me.
Yeah, but so he's just got used to the 16 adaptability roll, and that's why it's his favorite. You went to the wrong bonfire, PK. We want to get that Esther shot that you were missing. The Cardinal Tower.
Okay. What?
It's the what the fuck is it called? The Forest of the Giants.
Okay. Yeah, got it. I'm there.
Okay, where it be?
I don't know. Remember if you opened the shortcut.
So
the bomb shortcut, I don't think it is.
The bomb one? No. Okay. Oh, is it behind the bomb wall?
Yeah, behind the bomb wall.
Oh god.
Well, no, technically speaking, you can just... Oh yeah, you actually opened that, perfect.
What? Oh, that one.
Head forwards to past the Ninja Turtle.
Uh-huh. And
to the, then there's this big ass route that goes down.
Route?
You will see.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. Oh yeah, that one.
And you can, from this place, you can jump to the barricade or the scaffolding to the left of it. Or you can just roll down. Whatever you whatever suits you most.
Torch.
And you should see that there is like towards the side of the with the mountain part, there's a cave, and you want to get to this cave.
Where's the?
How you do that is up to you, because I have no fucking clue.
Where's the? Oh god, Ninja Turtle is here.
Yeah, Darkness too.
Raffaello?
The Ninja Turtle skin since Mites got released, by the way.
No, no, Raffaello. Raffaello was like.
Raffaello. No, it's Raphael, if anything.
Raphael, Michelangelo,
Donatello, and Leonardo. Donatello.
Donatello. I was about to say Doppio, but that's not Doppio. Right.
Doppio is Dark Souls. Is JoJo's. Just an OBK.
Okay.
No, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles skins got released on Smite the other day. And I gotta say, this is the worst thing I ever did.
Why?
Because... You know what's fun about these kind of games is when you look at an enemy and you know what he's going to do. And it's really hard to do that when four characters look pretty much the same.
So where the fuck is a cave here?
There should be a cave somewhere. You will.
I don't see a cave.
I don't know what, like how you get. I think from the front you are at Oh yeah, you there's when you head through the archway and you can roll down there. And then there's a ladder that will help you up.
What?
Yeah, where you are right now, there's a ladder somewhere.
Uh-huh.
And when you head up that and then follow the scaffolding, it will pretty much lead you to the...
This is weird.
Yeah, Dark Souls 2. by the way, if you, I hope you already have... Just... how do I say that? Piggy, have you seen the first Indiana Jones movie?
I... Is there gonna be a fucking boulder?
Maybe.
Oh god.
Yeah, you have to jump that, by the way. That's you have to gap falling. That's small ass gap, I think you see what I mean, though. It's a very...
That was weird.
Very generous jump.
Okay, then go into the cave.
Yeah, into the cave.
Whoa!
I told you!
Okay, that's a human effigy, not what I want.
Then head up where the boulder came from.
See, I was like, I'm not sure where to expect the boulder.
And then there's an NPC you can talk to.
Oh, I thought it was an enemy.
I actually killed him.
Oh. KO.
Anyways, but, yeah, KO.
On pizza?
Shut up. There's literally only one reason why I killed him, and that's because he has a pretty nice helm. Like, I know that sounds weird.
House key.
Yeah, that's what we wanted, by the way.
Okay.
Everything else is unnecessary. You can head back to Majora now.
Okay.
So, two things. In Majora is where you get the... Estus.
Oh, okay.
So,
Right, I'll use the homeward bomb.
Yeah, if you kill that guy, he will give you his helmet and I think, like, some weirdest weapon. I don't remember. But the helmet is one of the armor pieces that has a passive ability. And this is that it increases your, I think, vigor by 1 and your dex by 2.
Oh.
I'm actually gonna look it up because I think they were typing sounds right now. Bing and. Yep. Bing. Yeah, 2 dexterity and 1 endurance.
Huh.
And honestly, there's literally no reason to keep this guy alive.
So I could have killed him.
Yeah,
oh.
But you know, generally speaking, ill advised to kill NPCs and souls.
Eh.
Just so keep that in mind. So there's this one big ass house right behind the hole that I forced you to jump down earlier.
Where I died. Yeah.
Yeah, you can head into that now, and there's
okay.
In there is both a skeleton. Just so you know, I think 2 of them actually, and the item that we want.
Great.
You will see.
Bone Zones, where are you?
Spo- These guns, skeleton, sensuous down your spine. Shriek. You want to go into the basement?
I gotta explore a bit before that.
You do you.
Uh-huh.
I don't care. And
there's a chest there, that's why I explored. Aha. Titanite shard and a torch. Oh, three Titanite shards, holy shit. Nice.
Holy shit! Three Titanite shards? Yo!
Poggers?
Game changing! By the way, you can get infinite now.
What? Neat.
The Harvest Valley. The Harvest Valley introduces you to an NPC, which is one of the waifus of this game. And she sells you, like, upgrade materials.
Huh.
So the place that you just went in the basement with the small fires is the world map, by the way.
Huh.
And all the fires are major places that you had to go to.
The bone zone! Oh, that's a strong bone.
So somewhere down here should be an Esther shard. I don't remember where. Just have to look for that. I think you had to beat
already got it.
War. Okay, great.
Okay, where's the second bone? I want to kill him.
As I said, I think doesn't not me equal Darius.
Oh no, there's just another chest here.
So when you head back to the bonfire,
a soul vessel. Oh no, that sounds cool.
Actually, that is, but not for you.
Epic.
Because let me just look it up because I'm not 100% sure if I have things straight in mind. But I think I do. Yeah. You can remember the very beginning of the game with the old ladies. Before I continue talking, okay, you don't have that NPC yet. Good. You should change that soon. Anyways. Actually, you know what? You're actually gonna change it now because it bothers me.
What?
Go back to the Cardinal Tower.
Give me a sec, I'm gonna use the Estus first.
Yeah. Is that a shop here? In the Cardinal Tower, there's right next to our bonfire, there's an NPC that's like a shop lady.
Okay.
And when you buy, I think, 1,000 souls worth of goods, she will move to Majula. And when you have her in Majula, you can buy infinite life gems from her.
Oh!
For 300 apiece.
That's reasonable price at Filthy Acts.
I think what you want to say...
I know what I wanted to say, but I explicitly made it backwards.
I think you wanted to say malevolent misconducts acted out for the more than adequate monetary value.
Okay, so what do I do? Just talk to her, or...?
Yeah, just buy shit from her. Just like 1,000 souls worth of anything.
Okay, I'll buy some life gems, I guess.
Yeah, just buy all of the life gems, honestly.
Five life gems for...
Tariff drawing war? Check.
Or radiant life gems? Is that just a better life gem?
Drawing,
or?
Right? Yeah. Just buy.
Oh, there's also... I could also get the blacksmith key.
You don't have the blacksmith key yet? Yeah. Okay, no, you have.
Oh.
Okay, I was about to piss. Seraph got a bingo. Seraph got a bingo. Way.
Alright, let's buy some life gems. I'll buy...
No, I don't have anything.
Okay, then I misunderstood you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'll buy like... Five, that's fine.
Damn it.
Oh, she only had five, that's okay. So,
got a bingo.
Thank you kindly. Yeah, now what? I just talk to you?
That's it. You just...
Oh no, you don't. Yeah, don't. Yeah, you do.
Yeah, no, exhaust the dialogue with her.
Oh, okay.
She will then move to...
I've a bargain place with you next time we meet. Oh, okay. Okay, I guess. Cool. Majula, let's see if she appears there now.
Actually, she drops a pretty fucking radical thing. So when you kill her, she drops a covered silver snake ring plus one. That's... first of all, don't kill her.
Yeah.
But this ring increases the amount of money you get by 20%. It should be right next to the bonfire. There's like this cracked
wall. There she is. Hey, lady.
And she says the fuck off of life
gems. Lady.
Yeah, there we go. Now I can, like, I'll buy nine. But I got the cash, I'm rich.
She actually sells a fragrant branch, that's interesting. Hmm. That's good to know.
Okay, where are we?
Can you go into your inventory real quick and do me a favor?
Uh-huh.
I want to know if you have that. It's called the fragrant branch of yore. I have no idea what that icon is. It's like a small stick. It should be very, very far, very far.
I got it.
One?
One.
Yeah, good, perfect. Never, if the game ever asks you if you want to use that, don't. There's only a limited amount of them per playthrough. And most of them you get towards the later part of the game. But it's enough to use it everywhere you can use them. Uh-huh. So technically speaking, there's no wasting, but there are some things that, in my opinion, are a waste of it, so don't.
Okay, time to get poisoned now.
Yeah, have fun with that. So, what I want to say earlier is, like, the next place is a place you could technically know. Remember in Dark Souls 3...
Actually, does it ever wear off, the poison on the gloves?
I think it does at one point.
Yeah, it's going away.
Okay, so slowly. Remember in Dark Souls 3 in the last DLC, you had the first half of it was just like what I told said, like a amalgamation of like all the previous Dark Souls levels. And then we had the big ass swampy area with the where you had to climb on the roots. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the area that it was based on. Have fun!
Okay, so that poison is just gonna stay. Okay, that's not good.
I think, honestly, and this is, I know you will piss on that, but you just get used to being poisoned in this area. Keep an eye on your HP. This is a suicide run level, just so you know.
Oh boy.
I would still talk to the lady here.
Where's the lady here?
Just before you head down.
It looks like a hot spring for, wait, before I head, wait, what?
Before you head, go back up again. Like where you came from.
Oh, there, hi.
Also heal because poison is going to kill you.
Uh-huh.
Honestly, I like the poison in Dark Souls 2 because it does a fuck ton of damage, but at least it's gone quickly again.
So we already have a winner.
Just... Brothers, boingo boingo, PK, Emmet got its bingo.
Neat. Okay, so what do I do with her? Just talk or...?
Yeah, just talk to her. Cool. I think if you exhaust the dialect, she will move to Majula as well.
Okay.
Good job, Emmet. So she sells upgrade items.
Neat.
That's about it. Like, that's about everything nice I can say about her. She's one of the waifus of the game.
Yeah, those
people really, really
look
enjoy
good.
Her.
Okay, then,
currently, you cannot buy infinite of them. You can only buy 10 shards, but still. Sup, Aoki?
Oh, that would have also been a good bingo card.
Yeah. By the way, this misty place also poisons.
I had a feeling. That's a big boy.
Next week, I'll build new horror wings. I don't know what that means.
See if we can yeet through there. Whoa, what the fuck did that dude just do? He should have looked at me.
Yeah, that's like a small. This is like a big giant dude with like a smaller dude on his back, and he's just magic.
Oh.
Get far away from him.
What the?
Welcome in Waifu Heaven.
Fuck was that?
The desert pyromancers.
Thank you!
No problem! There's an Estus shard in this area, by the way. I think in one of the caves.
Thank you!
No problem, PK. Always here to help you! Also, you can get the Sunbrow Covenant in this place. I just want to further share that. That's all it.
Okay, let's see, where should I go then? Probably to that giant windmill tower thing.
As I said, I think someone in the caves is an Esther shot down here. Ugh. So with the poison misty thing.
That's gonna be interesting.
Not with the normal items lying around, I can tell you that much.
Okay.
100% sure of that. But I think there's a lot of Titanite shards in there, so if you really want to, you can get them down the line.
For now, I guess I'll see if there's any caves here that I can walk into, probably, maybe not. Oh, there's a... No, that's a rock.
That's I'm on a rock!
That's not a... That's not a cave, that's a rock!
It's not a boulder! It into a rock!
Hey, he went into the cavey. He did the wavy.
He got another fucking freak revenge of yore. I'm gonna piss my piss.
Oh yeah, piss. It's good to piss your piss, otherwise you get... What just happened? Oh, he backstabbed me.
Yeah, no, the skeletons can parry you.
Oh.
That was always a thing in Souls.
Okay.
The fun fact, actually, not all of them can do that because the skeleton lord skeletons cannot do that.
Okay.
Which would actually make this boss fight difficult.
I do love how the emotions from the wheel skeletons went from "Oh no, wheels!" to "Oh."
Oh, they're dead. Oh.
Oh, if I just run through the poison, I don't get poisoned because it disappears quicker. Instead of
I
floating.
Think if you continuously move, you also lose sound. But I'm not 100% sure of that.
I mean, it would be realistic.
I never learned to read the logic behind that because I'm just used to getting poisoned here. Because honestly, it's not dodgeable in my opinion. You have to get poisoned at one point. So
oh, that's a chest. Okay. Earlier. Excuse me?
Yeah, sometimes in chest there's like... Okay. Great.
It's nothing to do with the chest, it was the skeleton dude being rude.
Then ignore what I was talking about.
He was just like, excuse me!
What is happening with the fucking thumbnail at this point?
I don't know it, I haven't seen it yet, so...
There's like a fat thing with from a bookshelf.
What?
There's Lemmet with a Burger King claw because he won the bingo thing. There's Seraph being depressed, me being very thin, and you having a fuck ton of skeletons around your head. There's all doing the worm! I just realized that!
What is happening?
The fuck I mean? Oh, I get it because it's a fuck. Ah! Oh. Okay, yeah, now I get it.
Okay, next time I die, I have to look at that.
Because this woman is like the bingo roll cage thing to her.
What is that? Did you see that fucking weapon out there? Did you see that?
Yeah. Because I remember Wind Waker with good. Like Phantom Ganon showing you the way. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's showing you the way to the chest.
Oh, that's... That's good.
It's a puzzle.
Okay, so in there, that's not what I wanted.
Yeah, I have no fucking idea what the shot even is, I'm gonna look it up then.
Might as well just die in this raid, cause it's not worth it. I'll just spelunk some more items off here while I'm at it. Just drink real quick. I'll just grab all the items I can in here, because why not?
So, let me just harvest to... Billy. Is the shard.
Fucking not Minecraft, what the fuck?
Yeah, the Esther shards in Minecraft, I need those. Go away, Bonnie.
Skull of the First Sin Edition, thank you very much.
Oh. Okay, let's look at the mess armored mate.
Yeah, you changed the thing on the crown, but I can't see what you changed it to. That's
what
the issue.
What the fuck is that? Why is everyone so thin?
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Why is Emmet so much thicker than us?
When did Armit get a hold of that image of Jess?
You just did? Honestly.
Yeah.
You just want an image and bing bada bing bada boom, you have that.
Okay, so are you gonna look where the
yeah,
thing
I'm
is?
Looking at it.
Okay, cool. There's still some items I could grab, but I can't be arsed.
Oh, I know, that's still far bit further in.
Oh, okay. Okay, I'll wait till the poison tapers off a bit.
I should just get used to getting poison, honestly. Because if there's a pyromancer hit you, you're dead anyways. Don't worry, they one hit you.
Don't worry, they kill you. Good.
Like, honestly.
Yeah, I noticed.
On the other hand, to be fair, 99% of what I have in mind of this game is no death, no bonfire run, and you're severely underleveled when you're displaced. So, you know. Good riddance.
Hexing urn.
Yeah. So remember the firebombs in Dark Souls 3, and then you get the under firebombs. Yeah, it's the same, just with dark damage.
These guys are like a war zone over here. Jesus.
You can get these the fireball spell if she shoots as her own spell.
Oh my god, I want that.
You can lock onto them, you can also try using your own fireballs.
Yeah, I'd have to, yeah, there we go, I'm locking onto them. Okay, hey! Fuck you!
What you looking for?
Fuck you! I don't think that's gonna be enough to kill both of them.
Well, if you can kill one of them, that's already a good plus.
Yeah.
I would say try to kill the upper one of the fireballs, actually, not the lower one.
I can't lock. I don't think I can lock onto that one so easily.
Like, whoa! Like, I would just try to rush down the lower one. That would be about it for me.
Okay, let's kill that bitch. I said let's kill that bitch, come on.
Kill the hole.
Yes! Okay, pull that lever, I guess that activates that thing there. Excuse me, dear sir, could you please let me pull my lever in peace, thank you.
God. Excuse me, dear sir or madam.
The nerve of some people.
Whoa. Yeah, it opened something right in front of you.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so that's that, which means I won't... I'll have to play some Don Marco next time I run through here.
Hey, it's me, I can climb up the ladders. Ah, I died!
Yep, okay, I'm just gonna do that.
Oh, my screen mask is so hard to draw.
Wait, what is hard to draw?
War screaming now.
War.
Yeah, I mean, a screaming mouth is also like war. Okay, so this thing is open now. Let's see what's in here. Probably more death.
Just so you know, I just looked at Emmett's bingo card.
Oh, there's bonfire.
Nice. I just clicked at Emmett's bingo card, and I want to point out that he clicked dice to bad gameplay. And you know what? I'm just gonna click that for PK as well. Hey, yo, PK, you had a bingo.
Oh, cool. Thank you, game. Fuck you.
I can't fuck this game.
Yeah, you know what? That's a fucking
yeah, sure. What the fuck was that?
Those pop fucking with poison.
Why?
Yeah, why not? It's just a wall.
That's so pointless.
PK, in the other area that you would like in the hole, there are pots filled with acid or corrosive material that when you roll through them, that will break your equipment that you're currently wearing.
What?
Like that you have to go back and repair them.
Are you fucking...
Dark Souls 2?
Why?
Man, I just need to be vibing to get a bingo.
Yeah, I'm not letting you vibe. Okay, there's a chest down here, let's get that, I guess.
Yeah, but you really should get down to play some Dark Souls. Haha, I said that bingo.
Okay, I guess there's no choice but to go into the piss. I can't see in the piss.
I don't know.
I'm surprised we haven't... I don't see anything here, oh my god.
Dark Souls 2?
Oh my god, I'm literally blind.
I actually got nothing on Hololive, so...
Nothing new happened?
Talking about Hololive.
I have literally nothing to talk about.
Too late, it's talking about Hololive.
Wow, hey, I literally ran in circles just now, great.
Saying that you don't have to talk, have anything to say about a certain topic doesn't mean you're talking about a certain topic, first of all.
You also did one like that with yourself there.
Which one?
Right, where do I go? Where do I go? I don't... Is that the same ladder I just went up? I don't... No, it is not good.
Also, we had a winner. So.
Yeah, we have a winner regardless. PK came in and said, I guess, I don't even know. Emmett, which one did you click to get the bingo?
Why are you so competitive about this?
Honestly.
Oh god, there's explosions here. Okay, I guess that's the place I have to go.
Yeah, it's just.
Oh no, it's a token, guys. Okay.
Oh, piss. Didn't want that. No! Ow!
Whoa. What? Fucking ninja!
Yeah, but I mean, which one was last when you clicked to...
Oh, this is me! Yeah, get poisoned, fucker.
Yeah, by the way, this guy, we just collectively call him Shrek in the community. I think you can see why.
Yeah.
Oh. Get out of my swamp!
Yep. That's mean, though. Oh no, there's another Shrek!
So, the Vor one. Yeah, then. Technically speaking, then PK won because I just didn't consider dying to bad gameplay to be a thing today. But anyways, you won. Have your crown. I'm gonna change it for next year, next week.
Earthen Peak.
The Earthen Peak.
Ow, ow, ow.
Eh?
That's a nice welcome to the Earthen Peak. You're dead.
Yeah. How nice. Honestly, that is.
How nice.
PK, just so you know, this place is generally known to be the fun house. And there was a community ranking the other day about like the best areas in all of Dark Souls. And just like with all of the areas in Dark Souls being ranked by community. And this is collectively speaking the worst area in the entirety of Dark Souls.
I can see why.
You don't. You don't know.
Oh. I don't want to see why. Okay, I guess I go to the explosion lake again.
PK, it's like when you're learning to drive and like you say like, wow, driving a stick is really, really stressful, but that's really not the stressful part about it.
It's the other drivers.
I hate driving stick, by the way.
I'm driving automatic. That's my car is automatic. Yeah. I am not gonna bother learning to drive stick anymore. Just fuck it. Whoa.
Also, have fun being poisoned because Shrek breaks all the pots.
Yeah. I mean, it's his swamp. What do you expect? Go away, Shrek. Fuck you, Shrek.
I like how you picked up on that pretty much immediately. Like, it's Shrek.
I can agree with that. Like, I can agree with it.
Considering that eating sounds has already been made, I'm gonna grab some chips. Pombeer Original.
Oh my god, I haven't eaten. No, Pombeer, that's just the brand.
Yeah.
I haven't eaten Pombeer in forever.
I had the ketchup ones when I was at Seraph's.
The ketchup ones sound disgusting.
They're great.
Are they great?
They are really the,
Like, it sounds disgusting,
You know, like, the tomato ketchup has this, like, very, very, like... I don't want to say this spicy sweetness to it, if you know what I mean. Like the Heinz ones.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, this tastes just on chips, and it's really good.
Okay.
Like, hands down, in my opinion, one of the best chips.
Huh. I mean, I think I remember always just eating the salty ones.
Yeah. This is what I have right now.
Right, Shrek, let's Shrek.
Oh, yeah. Just so you know, the ninja guys are called Manakins.
Like, officially?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know why.
Huh.
Like, I know why they're named this, like, why we know that, but I don't know why they're named this.
Okay.
Cause we can get the...
Fuck you, game. Oh, wait, that's just that. Okay, that's just getting up. Still, fuck you, game. Actually, I wonder. Maybe. Can I do that? Yes! Oh, that didn't break enough. Okay, like here, let's do that.
Now what in the fuck am I looking at, Emmet?
There we go, open the path. Without poisoning myself, haha. And now I'm gonna get poisoned because Shrek is over here.
Yeah.
Oh no, he doesn't notice me, cool. Oh, but this one does.
So we know the enemies are called Manakins because we we can get their claws as a weapon and they're called Manakin claws.
Oh, why did I roll? Oh no, I'm covered. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh god, two Shreks. Oh, they're gonna poison you! Yeah! Just die! Yeah! Fuck yeah. I'll take it. Neat. Okay, let's keep going, I guess. To the whatever it's called, I don't remember.
Honestly, I have such a... Like, I had so many fucking ideas for the Dark Souls 2 thumbnail.
Which...
Because, like, Shreks and skeletons.
The Shrekatons. Shrelicans, there we go. Who are you?
Yeah, don't do that.
Ring of Steel Protection, thank you. Why don't you give me a Ring of Poison Protection? That would be nice.
Ring of Steel Protection, I think, just increases decreases damage you take.
Oh. Neat. Might use that someday. Okay, someone's gonna explode.
Yeah, that just increases that downright increases your defense stat.
What? What just happened? Did I get hit by the explosion or did I drown?
Drown.
Oh. How would I know?
Water in your mouth.
No, I mean, how would I know that that's drowning liquid and not just walking liquid?
You don't. Welcome to the urban peak.
Okay.
You wanna know something fun? You still haven't seen the worst of it.
Yeah, I thought as much. Right, Ring of Steel Protection. Let's equip it, why not? That gives me 52.7% weight.
I think you have a better helmet by now. Or better hand shoes.
Hand shoes?
Technically speaking, not wrong.
No, they're all kind of worse.
And not in the sense of better, but in the sense of wearing this.
I guess. You know,
the ring that was the plus one ring, huh?
That increases
your death by 75.
My so, death?
Defense.
Oh. I was like,
you die even harder.
I understood that one as well.
I hate you.
Okay.
Fuck, wrong layer.
Right then. Oh jeez. These explosions are really gonna be the end of me, I think.
Yeah. Welcome to the urban peak.
Uh-huh. Oh my god.
Welcome to the urban peak, kid. We got everything. We got poison, shrek, explosions,
more
and
poison.
Water. What does water do? It drowns you.
You don't wanna know. What did water do? Poison. And drowning. Yeet. Okay, let's just keep going because these explosions are not gonna get better.
I actually think it's more funny, like, we're gonna show other people, we got everything. Oh yeah, by the way, there's a boss up here.
Wait, what? Where? Oh! Nice. Not a long way then. But I'll still get poisoned somehow, probably.
I don't remember what challenge run that was, but this, the boss that you're going to do right, pacifist, I remember. Okay.
Why
so,
would you, what, pacifist? Yeah. How can you pacifist a game like this, but there's bosses you have to beat?
NPC summonings. You just never do something, and you just never do anything yourself.
That just sounds lazy.
This boss is
almost
impossible.
Fine,
on pacifist, because there's no NPC you can summon for him.
Oh, no.
So what you can do is there's pots in the room that can cause poisoning, and only if all of these pots connect, he gets poisoned just enough to die.
God, that sounds annoying. So how's the boss in general?
Have you seen Star Wars?
Yeah.
The fifth one. I think, or the sixth, I don't
remember. The Ice Planet one?
The original trilogy is the same one for me, like one big movie, but the one with Jabba the Hutt.
No, that's six.
Okay, then it's six. Remember Jabba the Hutt?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm gonna drop you some lore after you beat him, but that's about it.
So Jabba the Hutt is... And then you're just throwing like Star Wars lore.
Jabba the Hutt is the is currently speaking the leader, quote unquote, of the illegal corporation of people living in the Hutt space on the far, quote-unquote, east side of the known galaxy.
God, could you imagine Jabba the Hutt twerking?
Thank you.
I hate you.
Yeah, I can imagine it, and I am imagining it now.
You're welcome. Okay, let's see this Jabba the Hutt then. Covetous the... Oh! It's literally... Oh, this is... Oh, it's disgusting.
I love him.
Oh, it's literally the... That one Pikmin boss!
No, wait, that's a recording, fuck.
It's literally the Pikmin 2 boss, the female Bulbop queen.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Who just farts out babies and rolls around.
Sorry, talking about my mother.
No, but seriously, that's literally what that boss is. Oh my god. Empress Bulblax, there we go. That's the name, I think.
I don't fucking remember.
Have you ever played Pikmin 2?
I've played Pikmin 1.
Yeah, the boss is not in that game. Only the male version of that boss is there, and it's like, yeah.
I wanted to order Pikmin 3 for the longest time, but then I just like, I don't want to play Wii U.
Pikmin 3 is a fine game, I guess.
Yeah, but I don't want to play Wii U.
Yeah, you can buy it on Switch.
Yeah, but I don't want to play Wii U.
Yeah, don't buy it on Switch, because the Switch is shit.
Yeah, so I don't want to buy the Wii U.
Yeah, it's just a Wii U port, nothing more, nothing less. Okay, let's try not to stay sideways of him, maybe. Let's see what he does on his own.
Not a lot, actually.
He just flops, okay. is it like another... Oh, he swipes, okay, cool. Oh, he actually swipes so he gets to... So I get to the side of him, oh.
Yeah, good game design, PK. No, you remember that.
I mean, at least it's boss design. So he can get all his attacks off, even if you don't...
The skeleton lords.
The skeleton lords were shitty design, but they were funny, so...
Welcome to the bone zone.
It's funny. Flop. Whoa, he can actually flop quite a bit, though. Impressive.
I think he has, like, one attack that I really enjoy, and I hope you get to see that.
Does he vomit?
Continues to eat in silence.
God, this is a sad boss, honestly.
I'm going to get you! If I'm gonna tell you his lore, it's going to get even more sad.
Oh no. Oh no, he's late! No! Poor guy! Oh god! He tricked me! I was like, poor guy, but no! Yeah, he vomits. He vomits fire. Okay.
So that's one of the weird attacks he can do. But he has one more, and I really hope we get to see that.
Oh! The tongue!
That's another.
Another one.
No, actually, that was the one I was talking about.
Okay, yeah, so, that was kind of weird with the mouth as well.
Yeah, that's a grab.
I'm glad I did not get hit by that.
Do you remember in Ocarina of Time? Yeah, what were these slime things that when they attack you?
No,
don't
kill me! Oh my god, that was close.
There were these slime
slime
blob things that when they attacked you, they would take your shield.
The like-likes.
Yeah, this guy takes your entire armor.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, he eats you, undresses you, and spits you out.
Do I get it back if I kill him, though?
I think it's just disequipped.
Okay, good. Still, holy shit.
It never happened to me, so I don't know
good.
That.
Good. So, oh my god.
Once I have some lore about him.
Uh-huh.
So the Earthen Peak has a...
Oh, wait! Could I have just cheesed him by jumping up here?
Kinda.
Nice.
So the Earthen Peak has a quote-unquote queen, depending on who you ask what it is. And this guy really, really wanted to get down with her. Like, really wants to get down with her. Like, really get down with her.
But
and
he
was like, how can I impress such a lady of such magnificence?
By the way, real quick, is there a bonfire nearby?
Okay, go on,
I found it.
So, how can I impress such a fine specimen of a lady? And then he's like, I gotta need to eat until I'm a fat fuck. And he just ate, and ate, and ate, and turned into this. And here's the thing, we don't know if it worked or not. Because technically speaking, he is living close to her now. He is just done with it. What if fuck is Emmet even doing right now?
You know what? I'm hoping for my dude that he got laid. I'm hoping for it. Him. That he got laid. Yeah, okay, let's level up a bit. Two more level ups. What do I put in?
Dex, technically speaking, also has an advantage to you. In Swords 1 and 2, it does, at least in 3, they changed it a bit. That it increases spell cast time. So you shoot your fireballs faster.
Huh.
Not a lot, but it's a thing.
Mm-hmm. I think Endurance, probably. Yeah, let's go for that route now. It's only 2 level ups, that's fine. Okay. And I guess while I'm here, buy more life gems, just in case.
Yeah. Honestly, there's nothing wrong with buying life gems. Actually, there's something you will need to buy down the line, but not now.
I can do that after I kill the next boss.
Hmm?
I can do that after I kill the next boss, so I can... Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so, we killed a fat fuck, we killed bone zones. What's next in store for me? More poison?
I don't... First of all, welcome to the Earth One Peak. Uh-huh. This, like, now you're actually the funhouse part of the funhouse.
Oh, this looks like a straight up Zelda dungeon now.
Yeah, welcome to the funhouse.
Oh my god.
You have not done the paid storyline, if I'm not mistaken. But there's one point where it's like this, where Paige is like, ah, oh, there's some awfully fine treasure over there, but it's a really treacherous way to get there, so I really don't want to do that. And it's literally just like a five feet drop down, and like one room to the left, and there's the treasure.
Thank you, Paige. Okay, I think I'm done with the game for today.
Honestly.
Like, I beat 2 bosses, what do you want?
More.
Yeah.
In 10 minutes? Nah, not really.
Yeah, don't worry. Oh. You've done just about what I expected you to do today.
Wow. Is that good or bad?
No, that was pretty bad.
Oh.
I said just about, you asshole.
Fuck you.
Yeah, fuck you too.
Fucking asshole.
So anyways, the next item we would need to buy is a ring. The silver cat ring, to be more exact, so you can, what do you call that? Decrease falling damage, and I think you know what for.
Yeah.
So anyways, time to open paint.net.
It's the wonder to die.